Russian economics major. Coach, здравствуйте, which means like a pretty formal way to say hello. You know, he's ready to show off what he has.
So with the shelter, we gotta like, the first thing we need to do is we need to pick a location.
But at the same time, like, you can't deny what the situation is. The coach's been out here twice before. He knows some things. I think I have a really great advantage right now because I have this strong alliance where I really think at least a couple of people there are really, really sincere. Brandon, I'm a little more worried about only because I have this gut feeling. I feel like he's hiding something, but he's covered in all these tattoos. Really creepy. He could be some like reformed, you know, ex-gangster ready to praise God for 39 days. So I just need to keep my eye on him. There's a 5-person group in the tribe, which involves all the guys and me. Since there's 5 people, you gotta make sure that nobody feels at the bottom, right? So Albert and I feel pretty comfortable. Coach, I have a good bond with him. Rick is totally in. He keeps saying to me, you know, I'll be true to the end. Brandon, I'm a little more worried about only because he needs to feel like he has a pair in the group. And I feel like nobody's quite his pair yet. Then again, he's 19 years old. He's having a blast. I'm not sure if he's worried about it. But I think we're in a good position.
My name's Brandon Hance. I'm Russell Hance's nephew.
God, oh my God. I was in so much shock. We all didn't say anything after that. He is a loose cannon. And
there's a lot of tension between Brandon and Michaela. In his biblical terms, he'd probably call her like the whore of Babylon.
I think Brandon right now is just really torn between following whatever crazy religious beliefs he has, and yet at the same time, he like inherently in his bloodline is a devious jerk. I thought I had a 5 strong plus, you know, Edna alliance going, and it seems like we're gonna have to do some reshuffling, only because our alliance is based on trust. And just because you're in it doesn't mean we're always gonna trust you. We'll trust you until you do something wrong. And right now it looks more and more like Brandon is just a small, you know, Russell Hance. Brandon actually wants Edna to leave. He likes Michaela better now. He's changed his mind. She's no longer like, you know, the whore of the tribe, whatever he thought before. Now she's fantastic, but he's still gonna vote her out. I don't get it. He is nuts, absolutely nuts. I think Edna was kind of feeling on the outs, and I think that yesterday, Edna playing such an important role in the challenge, and then having that camaraderie at the movie where we were all just chilling and relaxing and hanging out, I really think that yesterday was a huge day for Edna to feel like she's a part of this tribe. Our tribe feeds off of this, you know, we're better than everyone, we're the religious tribe, we're a family, you know, we're nice to people. The other tribe looked absolutely devastated. Ozzy looked like he was gonna break down and cry, he was shaking. And the more we see them get upset and angry at each other, I think it just pumps our tribe up. Cochran should come with us because if this is all true, he's really on the outs of this tribe. I also believe that I think Cochran's feelings have been heard out a lot out here. And as smart as he is, I have a feeling that his decision is somewhat emotional as well. There's no other options and might as well have faith and wait and see what happens. Albert is trying to take control of this game and I'm the swing vote. So now I'm debating whether to stick with Coach or go with Albert's crazy plan. In the end of the day, it's a question of what will take me to the end. I think Albert thinks he has this great strategic mind, and I don't think he's come up with one good plan yet. His recent plan is to get Brandon out sooner. I guess I don't see the point in that, just because I feel like everyone is gonna go along with getting out Savai. Everyone is gonna go along with getting out Brandon and Edna first. The last thing I want is for things to be shaken up. Albert's the one who's always feeling uncomfortable. He's always wanting to make a big move. And sometimes I think he just wants to make a big move just for the hell of it. You go against the 5, you go against the 6. Yeah, we're gonna throw you in the fire. We're gonna chop your head off.
I always felt his personality is something Cochran has going for him out here. I mean, when I first came here, I felt kind of bad for Cochran. It seemed like people bullied him. But I can see now why people got annoyed with him. You know, I get frustrated by the kind of air he puts on. I think he's really proud of the move he made. And I think he still thinks that somebody will take him to the end. I don't like it. Cochran said, I know a lot of you feel indebted to me. I don't feel indebted to you. You know, screw you. He made an awful move. He should have stuck with his tribe.
Albert, Coach, myself. It's really the 3 of us calling the shots. But yeah, I mean, up to a point, I'm not too worried about keeping Cochran happy. I think he's first to go. My alliance is with 4 strong men who are, you know, slightly egotistical. And I think that my game has been pretty understated so far. And I'm kind of relying a lot on Final Tribal to kind of reveal how much I've done, how much I feel I've done strategically. But the game is outplay, outlast. Every day, the people in this tribe surprise me with the things they do, and every day I'm recalculating who I think the jury's gonna hate and who I think the jury's gonna love. And Brandon opened his mouth. He was really rude to Edna. There was no reason to tell her, we're all trying to get you out. That's just, I mean, that's a bullying thing to do. Brandon, I think, often thinks that an apology absolves all sins. And maybe that's true in church, but on Survivor, people are not as forgiving as, you know, Jesus Christ is. And Edna's not as forgiving, and the rest of the tribe, it didn't go unnoticed with us. I think Coach and I are really on the same page. We both recognize that Brandon has done things in the past, but I think you've seen a change in Brandon since the merge. Superficially, at least, he's the most loyal, the most trustworthy, the most godly man out here. And that's not somebody I would want to go to the final three with. Today, worst case scenario happened. Brandon won immunity. We were hoping to get Brandon out tonight. So I feel like the way to go right now is Albert.
What are you thinking?
Albert.
Coach and I both agreed that Albert has just been getting on our nerves more and more and more since the merge. He's been sneaky. He thinks he's more strategic than everyone else. Everything he does is the smartest, most strategic decision possible. And more, I'm feeling like Albert should go home tonight. It's so gratifying seeing everything with Albert being exposed, because now instead of a nice little blindside, he gets to go out looking even more pathetic than he's looked this whole game. Where is there strategic value
because
in
you don't
switching?
Care about
let
people,
me finish,
you don't
damn
care about
it.
People in the game.
Listen, where, so I can't, will you let me finish?
No, because
where is the strategic mind
right,
now?
Right.
It's like he's in the toilet bowl, and Brandon and Coach and I and Rick, we all get to have a little chance at flushing him down. He keeps kind of scrambling back up, but I think Jeff will put the final flush tonight.
Tribal was crazy, but it was fantastic. Brandon made one of the stupidest moves ever to be made and gave his necklace away. And I think the great thing is that Albert not giving back the necklace seemed like a really cowardly move in front of the jury. Watching the guys in the duel, Brandon was going like a maniac. And I guess the terrifying thing was Ozzy was still able to beat him. And if Ozzy keeps winning immunity, there's really only so much I can do.
Sophie with that wins immunity!
False. They are not dangerous at all. Sophie wins another immunity.
It's not just old loyalties that makes me want Ozzy out of the game. Ozzy hasn't respected me since day one.
That's bull.
When you don't talk more than a sentence to me, I mean, that's really disrespectful.
But I feel like you act like a spoiled brat out here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How?
That's what I... Well, every piece of information that I'm making my judgment off of has been given to me by people coming through Redemption saying, all Sophie does all day is sleep and hang out. She doesn't really do anything else.
I think although it's a game and you have to be strategic and you have to lie, there's ways to, keep your character intact. And I felt like I've done that this whole game. I felt like I haven't made personal attacks against people. I didn't do anything unnecessary to hurt people's feelings. And I felt like I was trying to make personal relationships. So when suddenly, after feeling like I've kept my character intact, when it's suddenly called into question, and even now when he's suddenly saying that it's everybody calling it into question, it does hurt.
You know, part of what's happening right now is 37 days.
I know.
In a game that can be brutal on your psyche.
I was thinking about how Ozzy said that it just didn't just come from him. And now I'm just worried that if it didn't just come from him, I'm this big, awful, so selfish, spoiled bitch. And it makes me regret coming.
Sophie, you're still in this game.
Sophie wins final immunity!
And you are the Dragon Slayer.
A new slayer is born!
Sophie, you certainly are, because in this game, from moment one, Ozzy was the dragon, and you friggin' slayed him.
Everything was riding on this challenge. Beating Ozzy was crucial. Ozzy had to be out of this game. And I think beyond that, being the one to beat Ozzy must be something I can hang my hat on come Final Tribal. We woke up and we go to Tree Mail, and there's just more food than I've eaten this whole entire time. And I couldn't help myself. I was hopping up and down like a bunny.
Here's a day 39.
Woo!
Yeah!
I'm not a sausage person. These are awesome.
After 39 days of deprivation, having this one day where we suddenly get everything, it's amazing. I think we're all really proud of ourselves today. I think we really are, realizing that, you know, we did it. Nobody can vote us out.
I truly don't have anything bad to say about you, and I'm not going to. I mean, there's nothing really for me to say about you.
I thought today more and more about my emotional breakdown at Tribal. I want to keep my composure tonight. The last thing I want to do is seem like this complete, you know, nut job, you know, crazy emotional crying, because I think that's somebody who doesn't deserve to go to the end. So I'm going to try to go in perhaps a bit more logically than emotionally.
Okay, so I'm just gonna cut to the chase. It's honor buffs. It's about outwitting, outlasting, and outplaying. And when it comes to outplaying, I felt like I held my own in challenges. When it came to individual immunity, I won 3 individual immunities. When it came to outwitting, I definitely felt like there were 2 parts to it. And one was the strategic part, and I felt like I did that well. I made a 5-person alliance from the beginning, and I wanted to keep that 5-person alliance to the end. And it wasn't necessarily the easiest thing to do, but I made sure that my strategy revolved around it. And then the other half of outwitting, I think, was the social game. And I think it became more clear to me a couple tribals ago that maybe I wasn't so good at the social game. I felt like I made some genuine friendships back at Upolu. But, you know, like, I'm not a used car salesman. Like, I came out here and I was myself. And I do think I was honest as possible. So I think I filled the requirements.
Sophie, the reason I find it hard to write your name down for $1 million is that you're the most condescending person I've ever met. You took 0 time to get to know anybody, really.
Definitely. I think I said this in the beginning. I mean, I think that's part of who I am. I think I am really hard to get to know, and I'm very blunt. I'm very intimidating, and I think that it's just part of, like, how I come off. And I think that after this game and after hearing all the feedback, I think it's not such a good quality as I thought it was. I thought it was strength.
Yeah, definitely not.
And I think it's weakness.
Okay, thanks.
Before I came to this game, I said, you know, I wish I was a man, because men in this game seem to be able to get 2 young girls to follow them to the end, and that's something I can't do. And when I met Coach, I saw him as the equivalent of a young girl. He was someone who said to me, my loyalty is worth more than $1 million.
I'm not a devious person. I'm not a strategist. And it came to bite me.
I think it's probably my fault, because I was his strategist, so.
I was original. Sophie and I really did make a lot of help.
The winner of Survivor South Pacific, Sophie.